So one of the things that I want to do is make some indoor mushroom beds in my building. Now, to do that, I need mycelium. Mycelium is the root system of the mushroom. The mushroom, think of the mushroom as the flower. The mycelium is the root that runs underground or in the wood, whatever the substrate is that it's growing from. So, in order to get mycelium, I need to get it from someone else who grows it, usually by purchasing it, or I need to find the mushrooms in the wild and then transfer the mycelium. So today I'm going to show you how I have transferred some mycelium from an oyster mushroom to coffee grounds. What I am not going to do is tell you how to identify an oyster mushroom. What I will tell you on that front is that you need to research and study on how to identify mushrooms, because some of them are quite difficult to identify. Some of them you have to actually look at their spores even under a microscope. So you need to do plenty of research, finding out what are the edible mushrooms in your area, what are the lookalikes that may be deadly, and you need to study and you need to really know your stuff. And then once you have done that, you need to forget all of that stuff and you need to go talk to an old mushroom harvester, mushroom hunter, or a mushroom grower in your area. Someone local. My uncle told me a long time ago, you have old mushroom hunters and you have bold mushroom hunters, but you don't have old bold mushroom hunters. So what that means is you need to find someone who's been doing it for a long time, because the longer they've been doing it, the better your chances are that they've got good information. Now, oyster mushrooms are one of my favorite mushrooms. I've grown them on mushroom logs before. This time the beds are going to be a little bit different for me. However, what I want to do is show you how I'm going to take a clump of wild oyster mushrooms and I'm going to transfer those to coffee grounds so that I have some mycelium to start my mushroom bed.
This area here used to be the stump of a pecan tree. And over the years, it established a colony of brown oyster mushrooms, and I've harvested those several times, but as you can see, the stump is almost completely gone. In fact, I'm very surprised to see this clump of mushrooms growing at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to harvest this cluster, and I'm going to use it to begin growing new mycelium to create an indoor mushroom bed. Let me show you guys what I'm doing. All right, so all I'm going to do is grasp this at the base and I'm going to pull this loose from the stump. And you see it comes, it's got some dirt and wood and things like that stuck to it. That's good. We want that. That's what is going to help us establish a new bed.
So we have our clump of oyster mushrooms here. And the mycelium is going to be here on this end where it was attached. All right, so let's set that aside for now. Let me show you. I've got a bag of coffee grounds here. These coffee grounds are fresh, but if you've been collecting coffee grounds for a little while to do this, make sure that you take them and put them back in the microwave, especially if you see any little fuzzy white patches on them. That's other funguses that are trying to establish. If you have other funguses growing in here, if they are a stronger, more aggressive fungus, they will beat out the mycelium for the oyster mushrooms. So you want coffee grounds that are not contaminated. So these are fresh, we're okay with these, but like I said, if you've been saving them for a little while, stick them in the microwave for a couple of minutes just to kill everything, and then let them cool back down before you put your oyster mushroom in there. So now I'm just going to take my knife and I'm going to cut my clump of mushrooms. I can take these now and I can use them, cook them, add them into something. This little stump at the end of the mushroom is no good for eating. So I'm just going to take this with my mycelium. I'm going to put it directly in my coffee grounds and I'm going to cover it over like that. All right, and that's it. Just make sure that you have uncontaminated, damp but not soggy coffee grounds. And then I'm just going to leave this in this grocery bag for 3 or 4 weeks to make sure I get a good start of mycelium. Okay, and let me show you. This is one that I started a couple of weeks ago. And this is what it looks like now. Okay, so you can see, give me just a minute to roll this bag down. Let me put the camera down. Okay, so here it is. This is the mycelium that I started a couple of weeks ago. You see how these coffee grounds are just in this big clump here, all this white growing on them. That is my oyster mushroom mycelium. I don't want to leave this out here in the sun too long. You want to take these bags after you finish with them. I just tie mine up and then I hang it over out of the way in a cool area. You don't need direct sunlight on this. In fact, you don't have to have sunlight on this at all. So just put this somewhere. Again, I may put some pinholes in the bottom of them just so they can drip out some of the moisture. But all I want to do here is give this a chance to establish and start growing mycelium on those coffee grounds. After that, I'll begin putting this into a bed of substrate that I put together. And let me talk to you guys about that in just a second. Let me put these down out of the way in the shade so nothing happens to them. Oyster mushrooms will grow on a lot of different things. You can grow them on the trees, on the logs themselves. You can do it in the sawdust. It'll grow in wheat straw. It'll grow on the coffee grounds. It'll grow on cardboard. So what I'm gonna do with my beds is I'll build the beds and I will put probably layers of cardboard, wheat straw, and then add in coffee grounds. And I'll take these grounds with the mycelium on them and I will put it in between those layers, keep it damp. Again, I don't want direct sunlight on it. I don't want it to dry out. I want it to stay dark and damp underneath there. So once I do that, it'll begin growing on the cardboard, on the straw. It'll start breaking that down. It'll produce mushrooms for us to eat, and then it'll make wonderful compost out of that stuff as well. So that's my plan. That's why I'm getting this started. There's been so much traffic here today. Planes, tractors, chainsaws, and cars going by. The noise has just been terrible here. I don't know what's going on. I hope you guys have been able to hear okay. I tried to use clips that I shot between all of the noise, so hopefully that works out for you. All right, so that's it. It's super simple. All I did was took the mushroom stump that I had left over, I put it in the fresh coffee grounds, and I'll hang that bag up in a cool, dark place for several weeks, let the mycelium really take hold. And then when I'm ready to start my mushroom beds, I probably won't start anything really big right off. I may do it in some containers or buckets. I may build a little small wooden bed that I can move around a little bit. But when I do add it to that bed, I'm going to use cardboard, wheat straw, and some more coffee grounds as I have them. And I'll make sure that I sterilize those. That's my substrate. And I'll make sure that I sterilize that first. And once I start doing that, I'll make another video and I'll show you guys how to do that, what I'm doing with it. But for now, that's it. I've got my mycelium started. I've got oyster mushrooms on the way. We'll see you guys next time. Remember to like, subscribe, turn on notifications, see what we're up to next. Bye.